In this episode, we will discuss the subjects of longitudinal sections of roads, cross sections of roads, the usage and benefits of these sections, and, mainly, we will discuss how to calculate the quantity of earth filling in a road embankment. After considering the road camber, the side slope of the embankment, and the undulated existing grounds, and also what all other different methods adopted to calculate that quantity. Why the quantity differs from each other. Which method is commonly adopted in the engineering field? Please watch till the end to understand clearly. Welcome to Civil Guru. These videos made in different languages, like English, Hindi, Tamil, and also in Arabic now. Please choose your desired language from our playlist. If you like this video, please like and subscribe now, and share it with your friends. Thank you. Now, let us get into the subject. The purpose of development of any road project is to connect any two major cities. The development shall be always considering the purpose of that road, such as industrial roads, or public transport, or combination of both, in order to design the strength of that particular road. Means, to design the pavement thickness, and their number of layers required, etc. And, also the frequency of traffic flow, with the forecast of next 20 years shall be considered, to design the number of laning required. The road alignment. While designing of any road project, the first design work is the road alignment. The factors to be considered while deciding the road alignment is 1. Connecting the maximum possible towns and villages along the route. 2. Possibly the shortest route. And 3. As much as possible economical, considering the minimum land acquisition and the minimum number of culverts and bridges required. Next is longitudinal section. The purpose of longitudinal section is to decide the profile level of the proposed road and to design the longitudinal gradient and the vertical curves. And also to decide where to introduce the culverts or bridges. For longitudinal sections, the levels taken at center line of proposed roads are considered. Generally, the levels are taken at the intervals of every 25 meters in plain area. And at every 5 to 10 meter intervals where the water flow area. Such as canals and rivers to assess the length and depth of the culverts or bridges required. And now we will see about the cross-section. The purpose of the cross-sectional levels are to calculate the cross-sectional area of road at any particular chainage. By using this cross-sectional area, the quantity of earth filling is calculated in road embankment. And the levels are taken, one at the center of the road. And at every 2.5 to 3.5 meter intervals, at both side, from the center line of road. Now, we will see in detail how the earthwork quantity is calculated. The given data, or known data from the project is the carriage width, 7 meters. Shoulder width, 1.5 meters at both side. Total carriage width is equal 7 plus 1.5 plus 1.5 is equal to 10 meters. Camber from center of the road is minus 2.5% at both side. Gradient of the road, plus 1 is to 500. And the embankment side slope is 2 is to 1. And the details of pavement is wearing course, 50 millimeter. DBM, 2 layers of 75 mm thick, which is equals 150 mm. Wet mix, 2 layers of 100 mm, which is equals 200 mm. Granular sub-base, 300 mm, a single layer. Now, the total thickness of pavement is 50 plus 150 plus 200 plus 300 equals 700 mm. Which is equal to 0.7 meters. Now, we are going to calculate the quantity of earthwork for a 25 meters stretch. Chainages, starting from 90 plus 250 to 90 plus 275. The known data from the project detail is, first chainage, 90 plus 250. FRL, which is finished road level, is 71.2. Now, let us calculate the formation level of the embankment. The formation level is finished road level minus the total pavement thickness. Accordingly, the formation level here is 71.2 minus 0.7 equals 70.5 meters. Now, let us calculate the formation level at the edge of the road. The given slope of the camber is 2.5%. This means minus 2.5 centimeters at every 1 meter length. The embankment width at the formation level is 10 meters. The camber flows at both sides, starting from the road center and ending after 5 meters in length, at the edge of the road. Accordingly, the formation level at the edge of the road is 5 meters into minus 2.5% equals minus 0.125 meters. This means the formation level at the edge of the embankment is 70.50 minus 0.125 equals 70.375 meters. For easy calculation purposes, let us take the average of these formation levels, which is 70.375 plus 70.5 plus 70.375 divided by 3, which is equals 211.25 divided by 3 equals 70.416. The average formation level at this chainage is 70.416. Now, let us see the field measurements taken at the site. After cleaning the site, the existing ground levels are taken. First level, at center of the road, which is 69.416. And in left-hand side, at 2.5-meter intervals, 69.516. At 5-meter intervals is 69.606. And, at 7.5 meters is 69.616. Similarly, at right-hand side, at 2.5 meters interval is 69.526. At 5 meters interval 69.626. And, at 7.5 meters is 69.616. To ease the calculations, let us take the average of existing ground level, which is 69.416 plus 69.516 plus 69.606 plus 69.616, plus 69.526 plus 69.626 plus 69.616, divided by 7. This equals to the average of existing ground level, which is 69.56 meters. Now, let us check the average depth of filling, which is also known as the embankment height. Average formation level minus average existing ground level gives the average depth of filling, which is 70.416 minus 69.56 is equal to 0.856 meters. Now, let us draw the cross-section of the embankment with a side slope ratio of 2:1 and derive the bottom width of embankment, and also calculate the area of embankment. The embankment height is 0.856, with the slope ratio 2, the width of the slope is 1.712 meters. The total bottom width is the width at formation level, plus additional width of the slope at both side, which is 10 plus 1.712 plus 1.712 equals 13.424 meters. To calculate the area of the embankment, let us follow the trapezoidal formula. 10 plus 13.424 divided by 2 into 0.856 equals 10.025 meter square. Now, let us check the next chainage of 90 plus 275. The finished road level for this chainage shall be calculated from the value of gradient given. Here the gradient is plus 1:500. Means 1 meter upward in 500 meters length. Now we have to calculate the difference in height for 25 meters length, which means 1 divided by 500 into 25 meters equals 0.05 meters. Add this value with finished road level of previous chainage, that is 71.2 plus 0.05 is equal to 71.25 meters. The FIL at chainage 90 plus 275 is 71.25 meters. Now, let us calculate the further requirements. the formation level at this point is 71.250 minus 0.7 equals 70.55 meters. The levels at the edge of embankment is 70.55 minus 0.125 is equal to 70.425 meters. The average formation levels is 70.425 plus 70.55 plus 70.425 divided by 3 is equal to 70.46. Now, the existing ground levels taken at center of the road is 69.306. And in left hand side, at 2.5 meter interval, 69.426. At 5 meter is 69.516. And at 7.5 meter is 69.616. Similarly, in at right hand side, at 2.5 meter interval, 69.516. At 5 meter, 69.576. And at 7.5 meter is 69.616. The average of existing ground level is 69.51. The average embankment height is 70.46 minus 69.51 is equal to 0.95 meters. The width of slope is 0.950 into 2 is equal to 1.9 meters at both side. The total bottom width of embankment is 10 plus 1.9 plus 1.9 is equal to 13.8. The area of the embankment is 10 plus 13.8 divided by 2 into 0.950 is equal to 11.305 meter square. Now, let us see how the earthwork quantity is calculated and what all other different methods adopted. Nowadays, computer technology is improved a lot. There are many methods of calculation are possible with the help of these technologies. Such as, the quantities can be calculated through AutoCAD. Also can be calculated through MS Excel. And there are many specialized, dedicated software is available for road projects. However, here we will see the types of methods adopted, which are commonly used in university exams and in public service exams. Those are 1. Midsection method. 2. Mean sectional area method. 3. Prismoidal method. Here, we will see about these three types in detail. We will calculate the quantity. Along with that, we will derive the formulas for each method. Now, we will see the midsection method. In midsection method, we have to determine the mean depth of these two cross sections and calculate the other data required. And create a new imaginary cross section at middle of these two chainage with the calculated new data. First, let us derive the mean depth. The mean depth, dm, is d1 plus d2 divided by 2, which is 0.856 plus 0.950 divided by 2, equals 0.903 meter. The quantity, or the volume, is calculated by multiplying this cross-sectional area into length. The cross-sectional area is calculated by dividing this trapezoidal into two shapes. First one is this rectangle. The area of this rectangle is b into dm. Second one is these two triangles. The area of these triangles is half into base into height. We have to multiply by 2 because there are two triangles in same size. And multiply by length, l. Here these two get cancelled. Accordingly, now the quantity equals to bdm plus base into height into l. Now, let us calculate the base width of the slope, sdm. According to the slope ratio, the base width is proportionate to vertical height. This means the base equals to slope ratio, s, into height, dm, which is sdm. Here, the given slope ratio is 2 in horizontal distance, while vertical height is 1. Now, the sdm is 2 into 0.903, which is 1.806 meters. Now, the area of this embankment is b into dm plus sdm into dm into length l. Accordingly, here the value is 10 into 0.903 plus 1.806 into 0.903 into 25, which equals to 9.030 plus 1.631 into 25. This gives the mean area of embankment 10.661 into length 25, which equals to 266.525 meters square. Next is the mean sectional area method. In this method, we shall take the area of each cross-section individually. Then, take the average of these two cross-sectional areas and multiply with the required length. Accordingly, the area of the first cross-section is A1 equals BD1 plus SD1 into D1, which is 10 into 0.856 plus 1.712 into 0.856. This gives the value of 10.025 meter square. And the area of the second cross section is A2 equals BD2 plus SD2 into D2, which is 10 into 0.95 plus 1.90 into 0.95. This gives the value of 11.305 meter square. Now, the mean area, AM, equals A1 plus A2, divided by 2, which is 10.025 plus 11.305, divided by 2. This gives the value of 10.665 meter square. And the quantity between these two chainages is the mean area AM into length L, which is 10.665 into 25. This gives the value of 266.625 meter square. And next is prismoidal method, which is most commonly used in the engineering field, and also considered as an accurate method of calculation. In this method, we have to remember a formula, which is the quantity Q equals A1 plus A2 plus 4AM into L by 6. Here, the AM means the area calculated in the mid-sectional method using the mean depth. Means 4AM equals 4 into BDM plus SDM into DM. Accordingly, the value is 10.025 plus 11.305 plus 4 times of 10.66 into 25 divided by 6, which gives the value of 266.558 meters square. Let us compare the value of these three types. The value calculated in mid-section method gives the lower value. The value calculated in mean sectional area method gives the higher value. And the value calculated in prismoidal method is middle of these two method, which is fair on the contractors as well as the client. So, the prismoidal method is most commonly adopted in engineering field. If you like these videos, please subscribe now and share with your friends. And also don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.